demonstrate how to turn this little bomber jacket into a puff jacket. So it's kind of fun and creative, and I'm excited to see how you guys play with this. This is definitely a lot more fun than that POM exercise we just finished. And as you can see my POM lines on my 3D avatar. That probably bothers you if you don't, if we're trying to get into the creative mode and play with the puff jacket design. So I'm gonna get rid of it by choosing my toggle menu. I'm gonna hover over, it's this last one here that says like 2D measurements, I think is what, I don't know why the thing's not coming up. But anyways, just click that thing. Let's see if the name will come up just so I can communicate with you. Show 2D measurements. Yeah, so you wanna hide 2D measurements if you don't wanna look at those POM measurements. Okay, so what we're gonna have to do is figure out how do you want your quilting for your puff jacket. You could do anything you want. And I encourage you to Google more videos on YouTube. A lot of people do this. One of the ones I saw, they selected both the outer seam and the inseam, I think the pattern, there we go. And then you right click and you say offset internal line. And, oh, maybe I didn't do the right one. I'm gonna say cancel. Let's hold shift and do that again. Okay, now we can do it. Right click. Distribute internal line between segment. That's what I was looking for. And I think why this is kind of cool is because it makes like different shapes since your segments are different shapes. So you can figure out, do you just want one? Probably not, right? And then do you, I don't know, you can kind of play with this stuff. And so, I don't know, I'm just kind of playing with these lines, however you want. Maybe we do this. Yeah. Anyway, so wherever your internal lines, those would be your puff lines. Okay, cool. So I think what I might do, I'm just going to say cancel, but play around with that. I'm going to actually just pick the bottom here. And I kind of want to demonstrate it on the back to start with. So, where's my back? Okay. And then this girl. There we go. Okay, so I don't, I wonder if I have to unlink it. I'm not even sure. Let's see here. I'm going to go ahead and say offset as internal line. How many do I want? Let's see. Oh, it's going the wrong way. Do you see that? It's going down. So I will say reverse the direction. That's pretty close together. That might be too many. So, maybe 2 inches is better. And you can type in a number like 1.5 inches. We'll do 1.75. And let's see, I'll do a few more. Okay, and then I'm gonna say, okay, I'm gonna select them all. Well, I think they come selected. Yeah, so they're selected. So now I'm gonna right click, and if I want, I can rotate them if I want, so maybe 45 degrees. And, oh, you know what? So they are linked, and this is perfect because I do want a quilting pattern. But if you didn't want a quilting pattern, you'd have to unlink this. But this is actually working out okay for me. So now I'm going to right-click, and I want to extend and trim each of these to the pattern outline. I don't need points on my pattern, so I'm just going to pick the first one. Okay, cool. And then, you know what? Maybe I would probably go in and offset some more to kind of fill in the space. Or maybe this is kind of cool the way it is. So anyways, the point is you get to put internal lines wherever the heck you want. They don't have to be straight lines. They can have corners. They can turn. We do also have this tool right here, the internal polygon line. So you can just draw your own special ones if you want like a special like heart shape or I don't know, or stars or whatever the heck you want. You can draw it whatever you want. Okay, so I have my internal lines drawn. Cool. So that's step one. Now what I want to do is basically select this pattern piece, and I think at this point I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna remove my linked editing. Okay, so now all of them are selected, and I'm gonna right click, and we have to clone over or under, I believe. So I guess I will clone it under. So it's gonna be another pattern piece that's just gonna be sewn directly underneath it. Now because I did that, all of this should be sewn together. So I'm gonna hit my sewing tool just to see, there are sew lines, do you see? So they knew to sew all these internal lines together they're going to sew this whole pattern piece together. So it's kind of like I just gave it a lining almost. Okay, so this bottom one is under, the top one is on top. So to do this, to make it puffy, you need to add pressure, which is kind of fun. And we'll actually play with this a little bit more. There's like a cool soccer ball file that Chloe shares that you can add pressure and put air in it. But today, so make sure your property editor is open. Today we're just going to add only a pressure of about 10, and we can't do it at the same time. So the bottom one, you're supposed to do negative 10, and the top one, you're supposed to do positive 10. And hopefully that works. If it doesn't, then I just got to reverse it. So the bottom, let's scroll down. So I'm looking for pressure. Here it is. They have a slider. I'm just going to type in negative 10. And then the one that's going to be on top, I'll type in a positive 10. Okay. So let's see what this is going to do. I'm just going to kind of turn her a little bit. I'm going to pan her, and I'm going to go ahead and simulate, see what happens. Yeah, so gave her a little puff. Do you guys see the puff happening? If you're like, that's not enough puff, I need more, then do more than 10. You know, you can type in whatever you like. I'm going to change the color of her fabric as well. So I'm going to pick this fabric. I'm going to select it. When the fabric is selected, the property editor pops up. And right away, I really want to change the color. So here you go. Color. Oh, wait, that's displacement. Oh, no, it's fine. Yeah, color. So I'm going to click it. Right now it has no color. Pick any color you want. I guess I'll just pick like one of the default reds that are here, and I'll say okay. Let's see here. You can also change your fabric. I'm going to scroll up to the top by changing the material. So it defaults to just like a matte, but sometimes it's kind of fun to have like a shiny or silk or maybe a velvet, I don't know, for this. So maybe I'll just do shiny for fun. And then there is a whole fabric library. Like, we're still kind of simple. We're just playing with I've been playing with just the default fabric that they give you. But you could kind of shop around and play with the material. Oh, not material. Fabric. There we are. You know, there's a little library that they have. You can even get more if you go to Closet, the CLO Materials. They even have more fabrics you can download for free. As well. Okay, so here we go. Also, if you guys have more questions about fabric, they do have a kit you can purchase. So if you have fabric like at, you know, in front of you that you want digitized, there's a kit that you can do to digitize really any fabric, which is kind of neat. So lots and lots of choices. But for now, I'm just using the default one. I did make it shiny and I changed it to red. Okay, so something else you might want to do is add some puckers to it. So there's a puckering tab right here. When you click it, it automatically puts you on the edit puckering tool. Right below it, we have a segment puckering tool. It also has, if you hold it down, I'm going to click it, free puckering. So just kind of like our sewing, remember our sewing tool, we have free sewing and segment sewing, same concept. And then they actually have an extra one called seamline puckering. So I'm wondering if that's actually good for us because I want puckering on all of these seams. So I'm going to try to grab that one. There we go. And okay. And I wonder if I have to click each one individually. Can I click them all? I'm not sure. I guess I'm just going to click each one individually. So it's going to add puckering on each of these seam lines. And it looks like I only have to do it to one. Pattern. It's, you know, the bottom one or the top one, which is good. Okay, almost finished. Okay, so let's see if that adds some puckering details. I do kind of see it already. Zooming in there. There's like a default, I think it's called like a normal map. There's other artworks you can download like if you didn't like this one, but again, that's a little advanced for where we are right now. I just wanted to introduce you to this puckering tool. There's, you can play around with some of the options if you like. You do not have to. Okay, so now I kind of want to see what this looks like. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up, and this might be cut off from my screen, but I'm going up to the top menu, and I'm choosing render. And I'm just going to do quality render in the 3D window. So it's just going to show me, it's going to make it a little bit nicer. You know what else I, ooh, there we go. There's my shine. So this is taking up more of my computer memory. So it's not a great thing to have on while you're pattern drafting, but it is kind of cool just to see. I am wondering if I should probably change my particle distance to a higher quality. So let's see if that did it automatically from that render tool. So I'm selecting that pattern. I'm actually going to hold shift, and I'm also going to select the other pattern piece, and I'm going to go to the property editor. Again, I'm in the pattern tool for this to work. Oh, there's particle distance. It went too fast. Yeah, right now it defaults at 20, which is kind of high, but that's good because it doesn't use as much as my computer memory, but I'm going to change it down to 5, and let's see if that makes it a higher rendering quality, perhaps. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and simulate. I also would like to deselect, so have that yellow in the way. Deselect, just clicking the background one time. Yeah, it is a nicer quality, I think. So that's kind of fun and cool. If you guys want to play around with that, you can see the stitching and whatnot. We haven't really gotten to render, but render is also a nice way to take some kind of more professional photos. We'll probably talk about it later. For now, you can just screenshot, or there is this thing some of you guys have found. You can do a snapshot, and you can just go to your 3D window. And let's see here. You have to name it first. I'll just say red bomber jacket. Remember where you're saving it. I'm saving it on my desktop. And so I kind of like to do the multi-view. You can choose if you want a transparent background or anything. If you don't want the model in it, you can just click the model away on the 3D window here. Oops. And you should be able to go back and forth. I think my computer's acting slow. Oh, I should unsimulate. Let me do that real quick. That may make it go a little faster. Here, I'm going to see if I can cancel out of this. Oh, there. Okay, it unsimulated a few. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click my toggle menu, and I'm going to get rid of the model. And so right now, you can choose, like, you know, I want the front view or the back view or whatever. If you're like, you know, so I'll just say front right now. So it kind of defaults to, like, if you had hit number 2 on the keypad. And then if you don't want that, you can always zoom in a little bit and get it where you want. Again, I don't have any quilting really on the front, so maybe I'll just kind of do an image like that. Maybe you want to zoom, whatever you want. And then if that's where you want, you just pick this little camera, and then it'll take a little JPEG of that. You can do, you know, up to 10 different views, or you can just do, like, you know, a couple of them, whatever you want. You can lay it out, and they'll just save it as one file. They also save them as individual files as well. So unless you check this, if you don't check that, it'll just save it as, you know, one file of the two images together. You can choose transparent background or not transparent background, up to you. I'll just hit save separate images, and okay, I'm gonna hit save. So that's just another way. It might be a nicer quality photo than your screenshot, possibly. So here's my 3 images that it just saved. Let's look at them. There you go. It's kind of cool. It almost looks real, huh? And I haven't even really worked that hard, like, rendering it. Like, this is just kind of a quick, fast render. So there you go. Wanted to share that with you. Have fun. Put some quilting, puff up those jackets, and let's see how they look.